Did you know that there are nature spirits who assist mankind on planet Earth? They need our help urgently. Please keep watching to learn how you can help them with the violet flame. There are four kinds of nature spirits, also called elementals, who tend to the nature processes of planet Earth. They are beings of fire, air, water, and earth. Today we will talk about the fiery salamanders who serve the fire element. I'll explain why they need our help so urgently and how you can help them. Did you know that you can develop a relationship with the elementals and work actively with them? I'll let you in on the secret of how to do that in just a second. Most people can see elementals. This doesn't mean, though, that they don't exist. Elementals help with building, repairing, and maintaining the earth. Many elementals live hundreds and even thousands of years. Elementals are not immortal because they were created like all growing things, for example, like plants and trees. However, elementals do have consciousness. This might be very surprising, but elementals marry and have children. They are very serious about their family responsibilities and have strong ties. Elementals have feelings and cry when their loved ones pass. So, let's talk about the salamanders. It's a funny name, isn't it? It comes from Europe and past ages, where sometimes when people put decaying logs on the fire in winter, an actual hibernating salamander would jump out of the log and into the flames. Salamanders have very flexible bodies, and in ancient alchemical drawings there are pictures of salamanders dancing in the flames. Fiery salamanders look like a liquid fire, which is also called rainbow fire. Think of it as a spiritual fire that constantly shifts and reflects the different rainbow colors, depending on what kind of work they are doing or what kind of light rays they need to pass through nature or through the bodies of those in their care. They can be 15, 30, or even 50 feet tall, which is 5, 10, and 15 meters. Some of them can even be 100 feet tall, which would be about 30 meters. But then they can reduce their size within a millisecond. As I said before, the fiery salamanders serve the fire element, which is the symbol of the Holy Spirit and God's Spirit. Fire has the highest spiritual vibration of all elements. Physical fire consumes that which is being burned, but spiritual fire burns without consuming. The salamanders sustain physical fire and infuse the molecules of everything you see with the spiritual fires of creation. They transfer fire for a candle, a bonfire, electricity, and so on. In simple terms, life or fire would be non-existent without them. Have you ever heard people say that they have no idea why Mother Earth is still alive, despite all the pollution and over-exploitation of natural resources that humans cause? Well, the elementals are the reason. For example, the salamanders take charge of all nuclear energies being used on our planet and help make sure that nothing goes wrong with these energies. They purify the earth and the people from negativity and impurifications that are so prevalent on this planet. Something that I find very interesting is that salamanders carry rods of white lightning as scepters of authority. They also work with the Seraphim of God, who are angels of fire. Oromasis and Diana, who are the supervisors of the fiery salamanders, have asked us to invoke the violet flame for all salamanders existing on this earth. But why do they need help? Well, elementals are like children. They get influenced enormously by what people do, both the good and the bad. As we all know, children can be manipulated in whatever direction people want them to be manipulated. The same is true for elementals. If you are a person filled with love, appreciation for God and life, and comfort and care for others, they will be your supporters who send back to you exactly those same vibrations. However, imagine someone who has very dark thoughts, fights all the time with others, and has a lot of resentment. This hurts the elementals, and they reflect that same kind of low vibrating energy into the world. Elementals mirror whatever emotional states people are in and take on those vibrations. I think that everybody who watches this video is aware of how many people in the world are emotionally unbalanced, especially with COVID restrictions being on the rise. Just imagine what this does to the elementals. At times and more often, elementals reach the limit of what they can bear and have to shake off these burdens of energy that we place upon them. This manifests in our world as natural upheavals and catastrophes, such as tornadoes, floods, huge fires, earthquakes, and all other meteorological disturbances you can think of. These things show us that the poor elementals are utterly overwhelmed and are crying out to us to relieve them of these burdens. You can see that elementals are true heroes whose job it is to keep our planet pure and clean and beautiful and to help us. Now it's time to help them. You can use the violet flame invocations for the elementals. While invoking the violet flame, you can imagine the fiery salamanders totally bathed in violet flame. Imagine and feel how uplifting the violet flame is for them and how much relief they can gain from our assistance. To make them feel even better, you can send them love and hug them in your visualizations. I use the violet flame every day for the elementals and imagine the fiery salamanders in the violet flame moving around the earth near nuclear power plants and other places where a lot of fire and heat is generated, like factories and metal production plants. I also imagine them around people. I visualize how they infuse their spiritual fire into our bodies and help us to be cleared from all negative energies and thoughts we may have. I imagine them stopping big bushfires and helping the firefighters. Now let me tell you the secret of how you can develop a relationship with the fiery salamanders. Aromasis and Diana say that if we help the elementals will want to stay close to us and serve us. They even said that thousands of elementals will be singing and anchoring the light of the violet flame around us. You can start speaking directly to them, like to a friend, to get to know them and earn their trust. This can take a while. They have seen people do many bad things to nature, so they want to test you to see if you are a trustworthy person who really cares about them and the environment. But once you have gained their trust, you can ask for their help and direct them. That's right. They want to serve you, which means you have to tell them what to do. You are their boss. You could ask them to bring fire or light when you need it, to purify your thoughts if you're having trouble with negative thought patterns, and you could send them out to control fires around the world. But as you ask them to do things for you, you also need to do something for them. Invoke spiritual light that eases their burdens. So don't forget, the violet flame is not only your best friend, but also theirs. They need you to invoke the violet flame for them, so why not give them this most magnificent gift? If you want to learn how to use the violet flame, check out my video, The Violet Flame Mantra Beginners, which is popping up at the right upper corner of this video right now. If you want to know more about the elementals, I recommend the Encyclopedia of the Summit Lighthouse and the book The Sacred Adventures, Book 3. These are the two main sources I've used for this video. I'll add both links below in the video description. Share your experience with the violet flame and the elementals with me in a comment below this video. If you like these videos, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. This helps me enormously to reach more light bearers like you. Thanks for watching and have a great violet flame day.